Welcome to lab 7 of day 2. In this lab, we'll try to understand how we can write for loops using C# program. So here's a simple lab what we will do. What we'll do is basically, the end user will go and put in a number. Any kind of number must be like, 5, 10, 15. And then by using the for loop, we will go and display all the numbers, right from 1 till that number. In other words, let's say that the end user goes and puts 5, then we will display like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's go and display a simple sentence here saying enter a numeric number, right? So now we will take that number into a temporary variable called as num. So we will do console.readline. Now, as we said previously, that console.readline actually gives out strings, and so we need to convert that to an integer, because at the left hand side we have an integer data type. So we'll say convert.toInt, and right. So what this program will do is it will actually go and take the number, and then we need to use a for loop here, and we need to go and display all the numbers, right from 1 till that number. In other words, if somebody goes and puts 10 into this num variable, then we need to display like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? So now we need to go and write a loop through all numbers till num variable. Okay, save this. Now, in order to write a for loop, we need to first type for. Now, for is a command. Start with brackets, okay, round brackets, and we need to define a temporary variable. Now, what this temporary variable is all about? This temporary variable will accommodate the running numbers, because when this loop is running, right, it will need one variable where you will store 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in this way. So it is, this variable is for the running value, when the for loop is running. Okay, so I'll just give this variable a name as int temp. We'll start this variable with value 0. After that, you have to type semicolon, and you need to say that this loop needs to run until this variable, is less than num, right? So whatever value is entered into num, run this loop until this condition is proper, okay, or this condition is satisfied. So I'm saying here that run until your temporary variable is below number. The time it goes above the number, just stop running the for loop. And finally, we have to say please go and increment this temp number. So increment means 1, 2, 3, do a plus plus, okay, and then curly bracket start and curly bracket run, curly bracket closed. Now this temp plus plus is, it also means basically increment by 1. In other words, it is nothing but this statement, it's just going and incrementing the value by 1. It's a shortcut way of writing plus 1, okay. So I'm going to use temp plus plus for now, and then I will say here console.writeLine the temp variable, right? And let me build this. So you can see like everything is succeeded here. Nice. So now this statement actually takes input from the end user, and the loop actually runs that loop until the variable value is coming up. So in other words, whatever value you have entered, it will just loop to that till that value and display all the numbers in a sequential manner. So let's see if this program runs or not. So let me do a control F5 now. So you can see basically it is showing me enter a numeric number. So let me enter 10, and you can see that it has displayed all the numbers from 0 to 9. Okay, now remember that why it did not display 10 is because I said greater than here, right? In other words, the time it becomes 10, right, it also becomes equal to. So he has excluded the equal to. So if I want to also display 10, then I need to say equal to. Now what will happen is if I do a control F5, now if I put a 10, it will also display the 10. So it was excluding the 10 because that condition, when the 10 is equal to 10, is not there, right? It was only greater than or less than, and the in between condition was not described in your check here. Okay, so if you want to display even the 10, then you have to use the equal to. Sometimes what happens is you would like to go and display the number in a reverse manner. In other words, probably somebody puts 10 here and you want to say that okay, start from the 10, means start from the number and go minus minus. In other words, start from 10 but display like 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 in this way. Now this temp minus minus is nothing but it is like saying like temp equal to temp minus 1. So it, you know, it decrements temp variable every time the for loop runs. Now this condition also has to be relooked here, because now this condition is no more appropriate, right? Because we are going to go and decrement the value like 9, 8, 7, 6. So this condition is valid until the value drops down till 0, but not less than that. So we want to display, let's say that if the end user puts a number saying 10, then it will say 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 and blah, blah, blah until it becomes 0. But we don't want to display like minus 1 or minus 2 or minus 3. Okay. So I'm just limiting this condition till here. Now if you run the program, right, now it will display the number in a reverse way. So if I do a control F5 here and if I say 10, oops, it's not displaying anything. Why? This takes this until 0 is greater than temp. Oh, I'm sorry. Until, you know, temp is greater than 0 or equal to 0. I'm sorry. This should be greater than, right? So in other words, this condition will run when it is 10. It is greater than 0. So it will do minus. Make it 9. Fine. It will go then. Okay, 9 is greater than 0. Yes. Again, execute it. 8 is greater than 0. Yes. Again, execute it. 7 is greater than 0 again. When it becomes 0 equal to 0, it says, no, this condition now is not proper, and it will then exit the for loop. So this should be greater than 0. Okay. Sorry for that. So control F5. Now let's do 10. So now you can see that basically it started from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, and it stopped at 0, because if you see our condition, we have said here that this should only display until the value is 0 or, you know, more than 0. So I hope that you enjoyed this session. In this session, we were trying to understand how to use for loops, you know, to go and loop through numeric numbers. Now, whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.correspond.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package, what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered, so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.correspond.com if you're interested. And you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. In the same way, you know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.